This is a test broadcast. I'm not going to do it live. It's pre-recorded, but I'll probably watch this broadcast when I upload it later tonight. And if you guys have any questions about what we're doing, you can ask in the comments, and so on and so forth. But anyhow, Service Arena, Red Deer, Alberta, the Red Deer Vipers taking on the Coaldale Copperheads just west of Lethbridge. Nolan Berner gets the start in between the pipes for Coaldale. And for the Red Deer Vipers, it is going to be Brandon Bilodeau as we start with this exhibition game in HJHL21. An exhibition a stream of all-star teams of sorts as the Red Deer Vipers win the draw and we are underway. I do not like this angle. I thought I'd try the true broadcast view and it is not great. There's a reason this is a... Whoops, not select sides. There's a reason this is a TV angle and not where the broadcasters actually call games from. This is more like where it happens from. We are underway in Red Deer and here come the Copperheads. Early chance. Here's Abbott right in, but he's knocked off the puck. Puck comes right to Brandon Bilodeau and he holds on. And this is an exhibition game, but we will start a season mode of sorts, as with all 15 Heritage Junior Hockey League teams will be created. Any teams won a championship in the last 5 years or so, that's usually the team that gets created, as this is a mismatch of all the Viper teams that have done so. This Coaldale team, kind of a combination of the last couple of years, they went to the HJHL Finals, and it should be fun. Should be fun, a lot of fun. Bexty against Wilson on the draw with the HHL season canceled this year. This is how we're going to have to make do. Here's Wilson. Wilson right in. Snaps one just wide on Berner. And Turner Sharp's got the puck. He puts it up to Ty Abbott. Abbott, he's going to try to step around Kalinowski. Still got the puck. Abbott jumps off. Anderson shot it. Good block there. Abbott's got it right back. Bexty for the line. Sharp. Now Anderson. Now Ty Abbott. Abbott to Bexty. Bexty shoots it. Good stop made by Brandon Bilodeau. And he will hold on as we play 2:03 gone here in this opening frame. Coaldale going to have a draw to the right side of Bilodeau. It is Jaden Smith on it against Declan Johnston. And Johnston will win it cleanly. As now here come the Red Deer Vipers. Knocked out the puck there hard was Hoppus. But it's going to come to Marsolier. And Marsolier starts out with it. Gives up Damian Chilbeck, the Provost native. Takes it in. Has it stolen from him. And now Sam Piskuski comes back the other way for Coaldale. Knocked out the puck neatly by Brett Marsolier. And Cale Lapointe's got it for Red Deer. Lapointe shovels this up to near side boards. Hoppus gives to Chopek. Chopek now to Marsolier. Lost it to Ty Anderson. And now tied up here is Smith. Smith, he lost control of the puck. Taken by Marsolier. D to D. And swings it there for Hoppus to the other side. Now Damian Chopek starts out of the Viper zone with it. Red Deer makes wholesale changes. Chopek now right in front of one-timer. Great save, Berner. And he holds on. 15:35 to go here in this exhibition contest. Cale Lapointe, or Red Deer Viper HJHL champion. Overtime hero, triple overtime winner over the Cochrane Generals back in 2017. As this is actually a rematch, almost player for player of the 2018 HJHL final. Ryan Tessmaker right out front to Reese Neville, and he nearly put the Copperheads up 1-0. Tessmaker right in the slot, and a great save made by Bilodeau. He holds on to that one. We'll get a draw deep in Red Deer territory. Reese Neville had a good look, and then Ryan Tessmaker got a real good chance. Ryan Tessmaker opened the scoring in the 2018 HJHL final at the Service Arena. Draw one by the Copperheads. Mitch Kodzchuk puts it down Williamson. Now Reese Neville trying to spin away from his check. Neville's got it back. Neville out front. He found Swanson. Swanson just put it wide. Now here comes Red Deer. Lane Sim. He's on the attack. Sim tries to take to the net. Right out front. Zarubiak scores. Tristan Zarubiak upstairs. Red Deer's got a 1-0 lead. Lane Sim below to assist on that one. What a feed. And the third line strikes for the Vipers. Unlikely that you would have picked Tristan Zarubiak to open the scoring, but indeed he does. Buries this one on Nolan Berner to the glove side. Red Deer jumps out front. 6 minutes into this one. As the Vipers strike first. Here's Goodall. Goodall in the middle. Spencer Yates now right down the middle, but a good defensive play turned in by Konstyuk. Langridge turned over. Now Shostakovsky shoots. That gets blocked. Comes to Goodall, far side corner. On the far side, Yates. Yates now. Shostakovsky shot blocker. Save by Nolan Berner. Here's Brandon Langridge. Langridge now Konstyuk. Konstyuk through the neutral zone. Poked off his stick. Got it right back. Mitch Konstyuk. Now to Horvath. Good save on Horvath by Brandon Bilodeau. He was right in tight. The Battle of the Snakes in the HJHL. Coaldale Copperheads, one of the younger teams in the league. I believe 2007. Their debut, and already have captured one HJHL championship and have been to multiple provincials. So a backhander from a sharp angle there. That was Bexty, gloved down by Bilodeau. 2015, the lone championship for the Copperheads, but went to back-to-back HJHL finals in 2018 and 2019, dropping both of those. The first one to these Vipers, the second one to the Airdrie Thunder. Here now that's on the near side, I didn't see who exactly that was, but the Vipers have control now. Logan Linnell. Linnell, he puts it over to the far side. Brody Kalinowski comes in. He centers it here for Wilson. Wilson turns it over, Turner Sharp, Ty Abbott, now to Brandon Haug. Haug tries to step around to his man, Haug, now maybe a two-on-one, Coaldale, Haug, one-timer, great save on Bexy. Coming across, making the save, Brandon Bilodeau. 10:57 to go here in the first period, 1-0 Red Deer leads. Only goal of the contest is Tristan Zarubiak. Now here's Keegan Kingwell, starting out with it for Red Deer. Kingwell stops up, waits, goes back to the line. Bailey lost it. He stepped into one, and he didn't miss it by much. Zarubiak's got the goal taken from him, though, by Calvin Swanson. Now Daychief up to Reese Neville. Neville tries to step around his man. It does. Neville's got a man in the net. Now backhander. That was Brandon Haug. But coming across, kicking it out with the left pad is Bilodeau. Here's now Bailey Lawson. Lawson, oh, puts a hard hit on Swanson. But now Reese Neville comes over the line, turned over to Sim. Lane Sim, left side, stops up, tries to go back to the line. Can't. Now here's Zarubiak right in front. Can't get a shot away. Sim finds it. And a backhand stop by Berner. Back and forth action we have here in Red Deer. Chase Williamson was the one who had the glorious backhand opportunity on Bilodeau. Faceoff coming out to the right of Nolan Berner. It is the draw won and controlled by the Red Deer Vipers. This one is now taken away by Brandon Langridge. Langridge sends this one up to Jed Horvath. Horvath has that one knocked off his stick. Now tied up by Declan Johnston, but the Copperheads able to win the battle. It comes down to Logan Middleton. Middleton down the far side, taken away from him. Good back pressure there by Damian Chopek. Now here come the Vipers over the line. That is Declan Johnston trying to step around Levi Anderson. Couldn't do so, though. Good defensive play turned in by Anderson. Now trying to dig this one loose. This is Brandon Langridge. Langridge now into the middle. Turner Sharp right in front of his own goal. Shovels this up to Jed Horvath. Horvath right into the middle. Middleton. Middleton tries to take around. Cannot. Now Langridge in behind the goal. Right up front. Middleton. Now to Horvath on the near side. He scores. Horvath beats Brandon Bilodeau. No chance. He kind of got lost on the near side. And this is Barsolier, who just overcommitted to Horvath. Horvath slips on the defensive side of big number 33 and gets a perfect feed from Logan Middleton, and the Coaldale Copperheads pull back even with Red Deer in this exhibition game. As Spencer Yates now on the draw gets Jaden Smith. We're even here with 6.5 to play in the opening frame. Shostakovsky taken from him. Here comes Piskuski. Sam Piskuski He's going to center it right out front. Smith got a shot away, but it got blocked. And now Jackson Goodall comes out with it for Red Deer. Goodall on the near side. Tries to make a move around his man. Turned it over. Piskuski's got it now for Coaldale. Piskuski over the middle. Yeah, he goes over to the far side, takes into the offensive zone, right in front for Smith, and he couldn't get a shot away. That puck will roll harmlessly there to Brandon Bilodeau, and he will cover it up. Brandon Bilodeau, a two-time HJHL champion, most of these Red Deer players are back-to-back HJHL champs, 2017, 2018. Draw is going to be one controlled by the Copperheads. Brandon Howe snapped one, and a glove save made by Bilodeau. As the draw will now come to the left side of Bilodeau again. 5:03 to go in the first period. Jaden Bechstein on the draw for Coaldale. Lost it cleanly. Now the Viper captain angle twitch shovels it up to Linnell. Linnell right in the middle. Different shoots. Blocker saved by Berner. Great save, Nolan Berner. Difference again. Wilson right in front to Linnell. Point blank. Stopped by Berner once more. As 4:21 remains here in the opening frame, both goaltenders have made some big stops, tied up at one. Tristan Zarubiak has the Viper goal. It is Jed Horvath who struck for the Coaldale Copperheads. Now Aiden Wilson snapping one from the high slot, got blocked. Penalty coming up, and it will go to the Red Deer Vipers. First power play of the game will go to the Copperheads. As that's Abbott on the far side. Now the whistle goes. Red Deer's touched it up. It is going to be Mac Difference going for hooking. Power play opportunity for the Coaldale Copperheads here. Draw to the right hand side of Bilodeau. Ty Abbott, Jaden Bexley, Jaden Smith are the power play unit of choice for the Copperheads. Red Deer wins the draw, and down the ice it will go. Ty Anderson to Levi Anderson, now to Abbott. Abbott steps over the line. Abbott knocked off the puck, got it right back. Abbott to Anderson, now to Smith. Back to the line, Anderson. Levi Anderson now. Shot blocked into the corner. It will come Kingwell, and all the way down the ice by the Red Deer defenseman, Keegan Kingwell. Ty Anderson. He gives to Jaden Smith, now to Ty Abbott. Abbott, right in the middle, Anderson, Smith, no, to the far side, Bechstein, blocker, save. What a stop by Bilodeau. Smith shoots, blocked by Kingwell. He's got control, and he nearly puts that one out of play. But fortunately for Kingwell, stays in, and the Copperheads have control again. Jaden Smith, hard hit, and that's going to be a great defensive play. That puts the Copperheads offside. Brandon Bilodeau makes an unbelievable stop here on Jaden Bechstein. Nearly puts the Coaldale Copperheads up a goal on the power play. Red Deer still shorthanded. Another 26 seconds, 2:01 to go here in the first period. Logan Linnell. Linnell with it for Red Deer. Over the line. Linnell over to the middle, and that's steered aside. Declan Johnston has now tied up in the corner. Turner Sharp. Now to Brandon Howe. Howe starts up over the line. Howe trying to step around Marsolier. Could not do so. Calvin Swanson into the corner. Knocked into the boards hard by Engeltwit. Up top, Neville. Now Middleton, a shot. That gets blocked, and it comes to Damian Chopek. Chopek now to Johnston. And here's Mac Difference. Difference shovels it in the middle for Clayton Neville. Neville now into the middle. Piskuski. Piskuski now coming in on the near side. Piskuski shoots. Good stop by Bilodeau, and he will hold on to that one. Is this is a replay here. Damian Chopek catches Neville hard. The 2:23s coming together. Face off left side of Bilodeau. Calvin Swanson on the draw gives Bailey Lawson. Lawson wins it cleanly, and you know he has it up through the middle of the ice. Final seconds coming off the clock here, but here's Tristan Zarubiak. He's got the Viper goal, and knocked off his stick. Lawson now has it behind the goal, up to the line, and that is going to do it. First period draws to a close. Tied up at one. As Tristan Zarubiak has the only Red Deer tally, Jed Horvath responds for the Coaldale Copperheads. Here's that Horvath goal. 1-1 through 20 here in Red Deer. Cool. I think this will go well. Coaldale heavily out shooting the Vipes, though. Welcome back inside the Service Arena. Second period about to get underway. So this is just an exhibition game. Regular season will get underway once all the teams have been inputted. I think I'm up to six now. So a little under halfway there. I'll try to get two done each of these days on a long weekend. That'll take a good chunk out of it. Should be ready to roll by next weekend. Now here's Difference right in front. Good blocker save by Nolan Berner. Jaden Bexty, he starts up with it. Here's Bexty. Bexty now a backhander save. The rebound sitting there. Brandon Bilodeau. He's going to cover that one up. As 18:53 remains here in the second period. Coaldale Red Deer tied up at one. Draw on the left side of Bilodeau here. This is going to be Aiden Wilson against Jaden Bexty on the draw. Bexty won it back to Sharp. Sharp now to Levi Anderson. Anderson now right out front. A shot got blocked on Ty Abbott. Ty Abbott nearly put the Copperheads up by a goal. Here's Difference. Difference stolen from him by Brandon Howe. Howe gave to Abbott. Abbott now tried to take away, and he will give it to Bexty. Nearly a two-on-one, but the opportunity for Coaldale disintegrates. Now here's Abbott, a shot blocked, and another penalty coming up to Red Deer. This one is another penalty. It's a tripping call this time on Brody Kalinowski. Oh boy, I don't know about that one. Kalinowski's gonna sit for tripping here, and Coaldale 0-for-1 on the man advantage thus far tonight. They did record one shot. And now here's Anderson coming right in off the point. A good pad save, kicking out with the right pad. Was Brandon Bilodeau. Howe down out of the corner. Another good stop by Bilodeau. A one-timer centered in front, but taken away by Jackson Goodall, and Red Deer will send the full 200. Brandon Howe puts up to Piskuski, stolen from him by Goodall. And now it squirts loose. Keegan Kingwell, D to D. Krzyzkowski banks this one off the glass and down the ice for Red Deer. Levi Anderson to Brandon Howe. Howe will start out for the Copperheads. Haugen in the middle, Piskuski. Piskuski, Haugen. Haugen in the middle, here's Anderson, he scores! Ty Anderson, the Coaldale captain, strikes on the power play for the Copperheads, and it's 2-1. Haugen, Piskuski get the assists. There's Ty Anderson. That's a good player, and he makes no mistake when he gets it in the slot and beats Brandon Bilodeau after kissing it off the iron and in. So the Red Deer Vipers down by a goal here in the second. Draw is going to be won and controlled by Red Deer here. Now Declan Johnson, a chance to get it right back. 2-1 Coaldale, 15:52 to go here in the second period. A power play goal courtesy Ty Abbott has the Copperheads on top. Draw to the left side of Nolan Berner is Declan Johnson against Jaden Smith on this faceoff, and it's won and controlled by the Coaldale Copperheads. Now coming in, Sam Piskuski. Round his man, Piskuski. Trying to put a high glove on Bilodeau, but he just missed. Now Piskuski's got it again. Sam Piskuski. Back to the top of the slot. That's Ty Anderson. He's got the Coaldale goal. Anderson battled there by Declan Johnston. Johnston turned it over, though. And now here's Brandon Langridge on the far side. Hard hit on him by Brett Marsolier, and Brett Hoppus has control with it for Red Deer in their defensive zone. Now here's Cale Lapointe. Lapointe starts out, taken away from him, but Hoppus there to support. Hoppus stolen from him by Clay Neville. Neville over the line, far side. Neville stops up top of the circles, into the middle, that's one go. Blocker save by Brandon Bilodeau. Great stop there as the Copperheads nearly took a two-goal lead here in the Vipers' own building. But now here's Damian Chopek through center. Chopek over the line, near side, stops up, over to the far side, Difference. Difference, Liddell in front, loose it all, it goes in. Clay Neville puts it in on himself. And I believe this will get credited to Logan Linnell. Red Deers tied the game. That is a bounce, to be sure. Since it was put into their own goal, it'll be Linnell unassisted. Reese Neville over the line, stolen from him by Angletwit, but he got it right back. Linnell's got the Vipers back even, and he turned that one over. Ryan Tessmaker to Konchuk. Konchuk now down the boards, Williams. Williams is stolen from him, and now here comes Mac Difference. Difference, he's only got one to beat. Difference shoots it, blocked it, goes to Mitch Konchuk. Konchuk now to Tessmaker. Tessmaker over to Reese Neville. Neville knocked off the puck. Neville's got it here for Coaldale. Neville in his own zone, comes out on the near side. Gains the red line and puts it in deep, gathered by Dalton Angletwit for the Vipers. D to D, Kalinowski turned over. Neville, he couldn't get a shot away. Kalinowski nearly an egregious turnover in the slot, but now here's Lane Sim with speed. Sim tries to make a move around his man. Sim tries to get a shot away. Now he does it, he scores! Lane Sim's got 2 points on the evening. He assisted on the initial goal, the Zarubiak goal. His original shot kind of flubbed on it, and I think Nolan Berner didn't expect him to get it back. Just as he's standing up, a heads-up play for Sim to snap this one five-hole, and the Red Deer Vipers have taken a lead once again. It's 3-2 Red Deer. And that one will go as Sim, Kalinowski, and Lawson, on the assist. Kalinowski and Lawson will pick those up. But it's 3-2 Red Deer. Hard hit on Connor Sullivan right at the line. And now this puck put in deep by the Vipers. Now here's Jackson Goodall. Goodall tied up on the near side, trying to dig this one out. Goodall still with it. Taken by Ty Abbott for the Copperheads. Brandon Haug in the middle. Haug now to Abbott. Abbott shoots, save, rebound. Billano got there before Haug did, and he'll cover it up. 8:56 to go, second period. Back-to-back goals have the Vipers back in front. Draw to the left side of Brandon Billano. Connor Sullivan starts out with it. Now Jackson Goodall. Goodall on the near side, right in the middle. Ben Shishkovsky, great defensive play made by Turner. Sharp takes it out now. Sharp over the line with it. Knocked into the boards. Comes down to Jed Horvath, right in the middle. Langridge. Langridge now Middleton. Now Clay Neville at the line near side. Puts this one in deep. Knocked down neatly by Horvath. Now to Langridge out front. And a good club save by Bilodeau goes behind the net. And now the Vipers control, but not for long. Take it away from Zarubiak. Here's Horvath. Jed Horvath, Daichi, now in front to Neville, he scores. Neville puts it around Brandon Bilodeau and slides it in on the backhand. Clayton Neville from Isaiah Daichi and Jed Horvath has tied the game back up for the Snakes from Coaldale. And the Coaldale Copperheads pull back even. It's now 3-3. Here in this second period. 7:13 to go. As we said, it's Clayton Neville from Isaiah Daichi from Jed Horvath as the Red Deer Vipers have surrendered a tying goal once more. Now here's a chance again for Coaldale. Anderson! Great save by Bilodeau in tight. But here's Smith. Smith shoots it. Bilodeau is going to have that one roll harmlessly to him, and he will cover that up. Face-off right side of Brandon Bilodeau. 6.5 exactly to go here in this second period. Brody Kalinowski in behind his own goal. Puts this one into the middle up there for Difference. Difference trying to get this out. He does. but Piscusi will come right back in onside for the Copperheads. Now here's Smith, shoots it. Good save from a long ways out by Dillado. Angle to it. Gets it now to Aiden Wilson. Wilson now to Difference. Difference to the far side. Couldn't get it to his man, though. Daichi wins the battle out of a scramble in front. A hard hit, though, and the Copperheads will come back out with it. But not for long. Now it's right in front to Aiden Wilson. And Aiden Wilson nearly got the Vipers back in front. But a good stop in tight by Nolan Berner. Here's Sam Piskuski. Piskuski with it for the Copperheads. In behind the goal, this is Ty Anderson. Right out front for Smith. Couldn't get a shot away. Loose in front still. Gathered by Damian Chopek. Chopek now to Mac Difference. Difference starts in over the line with it here on the near side. Mac Difference. Down to Linnell. Linnell, a blocker save turned in on him by Nolan Berner. Great save. Ryan Tessmaker's now got it on the near side in the corner. Skates over to the far side. But he's pestered, and it's taken away by Linnell. Linnell back to the line, Chopek. Chopek, Difference. Difference back to the point. And Marsolier almost turned it over, but now comes over to Wilson. Great glove save by Nolan Berner. Still tied up here at 3. 2:37 to go here in the second period. Logan Linnell, great opportunity right in front there, but a blocker save by Nolan Berner keeps this a tied hockey game. 2:37 remains here. Draw one by the Vipers offensive zone. Hoppus, Chopek, Marsolier. Marsolier now Hoppus. Here's Declan Johnston. Oh, and a great glove save. Flashing the leather, Nolan Berner. Again, keeps this one tied. Johnston right in front. High slot, trying to pick it. High corner on Berner. But he's able to keep this one tied up again. Now here's Cale Lapointe. LaPointe, Johnston, another chance and another glove save by Nolan Berner. 1:56 to go, second period, tied up at 3. These two teams with snake monikers in the HJHL, the Red Deer Vipers and the Coaldale Copperheads doing battle here at the Service Arena. Brandon Houck starts out over the center, now over the line on the far side, tries to center it to Bexty, and a glove save by Bilodeau. Berner and Bilodeau trading glove saves at either end. Jaden Bexty nearly gives the Coaldale Copperheads a 4-3 advantage late in the second, but Bilodeau says, nah-uh. Now here are the Copperheads, again a one-timer from the line, Levi Anderson. Missed that one wide. Here's Brett Hoppus. Knocked off his stick, but Hoppus has it back right in front to Johnston. Another chance for Declan Johnston. And another save by Nolan Berner. 46.1. That's what's left here in the second period. Kalinowski turns in 3 blocked shots thus far tonight. This is an exhibition game from the Service Arena. Levi Anderson now to Turner Sharp. Here's Jaden Bexty starting out with it. Bexty trying to make a move to the middle. He does. Centers it. Here's Tristan Zarubiak. Take it away from him. Zarubiak trying to step around his man. It does. Zarubiak tries to take it to the net. Right in front. There's Lawson and Sim in the vicinity. None of them can find it. And that will do it. Period number 2 comes to a close. Brandon Bilodeau and the Red Deer Vipers. They are taking a tie in the lockers here. Coaldale's got to be pretty happy with that, as many a HJHL team has struggled to win in this building in the past. But 20 minutes going into the third, you take that. 20 minutes to decide this thing coming up next. 3-3 through 40 here in Red Deer. Welcome back, Service Arena. Third period action coming up between the Vipers and the Copperheads. Bexty and Wilson will go to work on the draw here to start the third. And it's one and controlled by the Vipers, but now Brandon Houck, can he capitalize on a turnover? Bexty hit the outside of the post. Abbott right in front. Abbott tried to center it to Houck. Comes to center Sharp. Houck now tried to center that one, but it's intercepted by his number 8 counterpart, Brody Kalinowski, and the Vipers have control. Kalinowski's got it right back from Engeltwit. Now he shovels that one up to Wilson. Wilson to the near side for Difference. And a good hit there. Knocks Mac Difference off the puck when Brandon Haug has it in his own zone for the Coaldale Copperheads. Well, here's Abbott. Abbott to Bextie. Bextie tries to go back to the line. Now here's a chance. Levi Anderson. Kalinowski out of a block shot. Comes back the other way. Kalinowski. He's got a man with him. Kalinowski to Lindell. He scores! The Vipers strike early in the third and take a 4-3 lead. Logan Liddell, his second of the hockey game. What a feed from Brody Kalinowski. Slips this one around. Turner Sharp. And he just does just enough to change the angle and put this one on a platter for Logan Liddell, who lifts that one up and over Nolan Berner. 4-3 Red Deer. Gaethje now to Anderson. Anderson, oh, he got knocked down hard by Marsolier. And now here comes Declan Johnson. What a move around his man. Johnston shoots it. Great save by Berner. Johnston, he's been all over it tonight. But Nolan Berner keeps that out. Lapointe, Marsolier. Marsolier at the line. Here's Brett Hoppus. Shoots it. Love save Berner. He's going to hold on to that. So we'll get a draw here deep in Coaldale territory. 3:20 gone here in this third period. Red Deer has taken a 4-3 lead. Faceoff left side of Berner. Jaden Smith on the draw against Declan Johnston. What a clean one. And now here's Hoppus right in front. Johnston. Good glove save made by Nolan Berner. He will hold on. Faceoff coming to the left side of Berner here. It's Jaden Smith on it against Johnston again. There's Abbott. 15 minutes of ice time for the Coaldale Copperheads. Bit of a tough night, though, for him. He's minus two. And now Brett Hoppus on the steal. Trying to step around Clay Neville, but he does a good job to just ensure Hoppus is just hard enough time to allow Piskuski to come back and help out. Here's Isaiah Dechief, now to Piskuski in the middle. As it comes up to Bailey Lawson, Lawson takes it out. Lawson tries to put this one in deep and can't. Lawson tries to center it to Clayton Neville, a great offer, great chance to defend there, and he does. Neville takes that away. Bounces this one off the wards. This will come to Swanson. Swanson right in front, Reese Neville, and a great save by Bilodeau again. Coaldale trying to tie this hockey game up for the third time tonight. They did have a 2-1 lead at one point. Lawson on the draw against Calvin Swanson. Lawson won it cleanly. But the Copperheads, they have control now in the offensive zone. Neville in deep. Neville back to the line. Kessmaker back to the D2D Konchuk. Now right in front, right from the slot, winding up. That was Neville. But a good job to knock him off the puck by Bailey Lawson. Now Zarubiak to Lane Sim. Sim, he turns it over. This is Ryan Tessmaker. Tessmaker to Jed Horvath. Horvath shoots. Save the rebound. Can't put it home. As Brandon Bilodeau standing tall. Red Deer still up by a goal. 13 minutes to go here. Third period. Sim's got it back. Sim, a shot. Kick save made by Nolan Berner. Sim to Goodall. Goodall's off the bench. Now it comes to Sim. Sim turns it over, and here come the Copperheads. Oh, and a hard hit on Spencer Yates. Maybe that'll get the Copperheads going here. Jed Horvath, what a move. Horvath shoots it, goes just wide. Tessmaker, he's got it to the line. D2D Konchuk, now the Langren shot. Great save, right pad by Brandon Bilodeau. Yates, Keegan Kingwell. Kingwell comes out with it. Turned it over, got it back. Now here's Shostakovsky. Then Shostakovsky, the Calgary native. Under the middle, Wilson. Now Sullivan. Now here's Kingwell shooting. Glove saved by Berner. And he will hold on just about halfway through the third period. It is 4-3 for the Red Deer Vipers. Bilodeau had to make a big save there on Brandon Langridge. Wilson, Linnell difference out there. Against their other top line, against the top line counterparts, I should say, Bextie, Haug, and Abbott. And now here comes Haug with it over the line in the offensive zone to Abbott. Abbott cannot get a shot away. Oh my goodness, Ty Abbott had a glorious opportunity to tie it. Maybe got a little too cute there. Now here's Liddell. Liddell, a back hitter. Mac Difference back to the line. Dalton Engeltwit. Engeltwit, Wilson, hard hit on him by Brandon Howe. Hard hit again. And oh, this one's going to result in a penalty call on Coaldale. Here's Difference, a shot. Blocker save. Finally touched up by the Copperheads. This one's going to be a charge on Ty Abbott. Inopportune penalty for the Coaldale Copperheads there, no doubt. He flattens Logan Linnell. And Ty Abbott does not like it. It's a charging minor. Red Deer to their first man advantage of the hockey game. Maybe a chance to plunge the dagger. We shall see. Left side draw for Berner. It's won cleanly by his teammates, though. Levi Anderson shovels that one in deep. Dalton Engeltwit in behind his own goal. Shovels this one up to Spencer Yates. Yates, now here's Brett Hoppus. Hoppus into the middle. Jacqueline Johnston, a shot blocked by Reese Neville. And Neville lifts this one the full length of the ice. Red Deer has to regroup. Comes down to Declan Johnston. Buck 08 to go on the power play for the Vipers. Nifty move by Johnston. Right in front, one-timer, glove save, Nolan Berner. 8:14 to go here, third period. Red Deer 4, Coaldale 3. This power play unit staying out there for the Vipers. Johnston, Hoppus, and Yates. Bexty and Pastuski are charged with killing it. And this comes to Berner, and Clayton Neville will take that one and get it down the ice. Declan Johnston, he puts it in retreats into his own zone for Kingwell. Now Hoppus over to Declan Johnston. 30 seconds to go in the Red Deer power play. Johnston up top, Kingwell shooting. That one bounces off a couple of bodies, gets toward the net, but held out by Berner. Now tied up near side corner. Copperheads come out with it to turn it over. Here's Kalinowski, a shot deflected. Great job by Berner to stay with it. 7:10 to go here in the third period. Red Deer by a single goal. Clay Neville over the line, now gives to Abbott. Abbott to Pastuski. Pastuski, he takes the net, glove save, Brandon Bilodeau. He holds on. Keegan Kingwell had an opportunity here to take the lead for, to extend the lead for Red Deer, I should say. His shot gets blocked on the way through. Hoppus, Johnston, LaPointe out there for Red Deer. Jaden Smith, Sam Pastuski, and Ty Anderson for the Copperheads. Now here's Pastuski. Got it on off the draw. A set play for Coaldale, but a blocker save made on him by Bilodeau. Ty Anderson winds and fires. Glove save made by Bilodeau. Bounces into the near side corner. 6 minutes to go here, third period. Now trying to put this thing up and out. The Vipers will get it out. Levi Anderson, however, gains control, takes a shot along the Red Deer bench from Declan Johnston. This put in deep by Coaldale, however. Brent Marsolier shovels this one up the right side boards. That's for Zerubiak. Zerubiak steps around his man, trying to take to the net. Can't. Now comes to the line. Marsolier off the point. Can't get a shot away. Marsolier gets one away now. It comes off the end boards right back to Nolan Berner. Covers it up. 4:30. To go here in this third period. Red Deer 4, Coaldale 3. Oh, I can do that? That's nuts. I guess I can look around with my controller. That's pretty cool on cutscenes. And here's Reese Neville. Neville, he gets it to Williamson. Williamson and the Copperheads desperately seeking a tie. And now here's Williamson. He takes it to the net. Great save, Bilodeau! Williamson, a beautiful job to squeeze by his man and turn it into a two-on-one. He took it himself. Bilodeau keeps it out. And with 3.5 to play, we're still tied. Now here's Calvin Swanson. Maybe another opportunity for Coaldale. Reese Neville shot it. He got hit as he shot, though, and he couldn't get a good shot away. Now Mac Difference. Difference to Wilson, the Sylvan Lake native. So Wilson right up front to Linnell. He scores! Logan Linnell's third of the game. That's a hat trick. Hat trick Liddell. That is something that's a phrase that might give the Coaldale Copperheads a bit of PTSD. Hat trick Logan Liddell. But he's got one in this one, and it's a 5-3 Viper lead late in the third. What a feed here. by Wilson. Liddell goes backhand to forehand, and actually Berner got a piece of that with the butt end of his stick, but not enough. 5-3 for the Red Deer Vipers with 2:52 to go here in the third period. And now a lot of work to do as Kodzczyk turns this one over to Liddell again. Liddell up top, Kalinowski shoots it. Good stop, Berner. Bexty's got it. We'll keep an eye on Berner here as the he's probably going to be coming out of the net in short order. Here's Kodzczyk. Now to Abbott. Abbott, 2 minutes to play. Turns that one over to Linnell. Linnell now to Difference. Difference comes over the red line, gives it to Wilson here in the middle. Wilson shoots it. Club save Berner, and he is indeed going to hold on to that with a 1:34 to go in the third period. Red Deer looking good, up by a deuce. We'll keep an eye on Berner if the Copperheads can win this draw and start getting this one down ice right away. I'd imagine he'll be heading to the bench. Here's Yates. Yates back to the line. Chopek. Goodall. Goodall, Marsolier. Now Chopek now. Yates. Marsolier, Krzyzkowski. Yates out on the far side. Great chance there. And here come the Copperheads. And indeed, out of the net will go Berner. I think he'll go back in now, though, as it's turned over. 50 seconds to go. Here now is Jackson Goodall. Goodall on the near side. Krzyzkowski intercepted here by Logan Middleton. And Kodzczyk took a hard hit. Horvat down to Middleton. And now it'll be empty net indeed for Coaldale here. And they will get him to the bench. As just as it's turned over, the chance for Zarubiak there. Shot got blocked. Mitch Kodzczyk. Logan Middleton. Middleton now to Horvat. Horvat tries to take that one around his man. Can't do so. Brett Marsolier turns that one over to Bailey Lawson. Lawson turned it over to Abbott. Abbott neutral zone, and this one should be over now as an empty net for Coaldale. Final 10 seconds, gonna tick off the clock. And the first exhibition game here of the HJHL21 streams will go the way of the Vipers. There's a battle of the snakes. Goes Red Deer's way. It'll be a 5-3 final. Hard hit on Middleton there by Brett Marsolier. His face-off to the left of Bilodeau. This will be a done deal. Vipers win it! Five-three is your final. Brandon Bilodeau and his gang will celebrate an exhibition victory here this afternoon at home over the Coaldale Copperheads. As we'll do some more exhibition games before we actually get started, but I might keep you here for a little bit after the stream just to go through some stuff. But anyhow, it's fun. It's really fun. So this will be not live. This will be a premiere tonight. I'll kind of hang out on the stream and answer some questions in the comments. Or just hang out, you know, Saturday night, have some beers, long weekend. Should be a good time. So third star tonight, Lane Sim. That is my kid brother. Would not have had a lot of three-star honors in his HJHL career. He gets one today. Brody Kalinowski, a couple of apples for him. That's a second star. This is cool about NHL 21, eh? Shows some highlights. Look at that feed. Linnell buries it. First star should not be too much of a surprise. This guy did have a couple of first-star, would have had a couple of first-star honors in his career. Logan Linnell, that guy was not bad at hockey from what I can remember. But anyway, that's the stream. Good times. Tristan Zarubiak opens a scoring there on a great feed from Lane Sim. So that's it. Anyway, let's just reading some stuff. Let's get some details out of the way. So what we're planning on doing, so let's first of all take you through what is actually happening. So HHL canceled. Fuck COVID, whatever. So I've gone ahead and created all the teams, all 15 teams in the game. Now it's just a matter of creating the rosters. So as you can imagine, you know, you got to create 22, 25 guys per team. That takes about an hour and a half per team. So my plan is I'll get two teams every day this weekend here. It's a long weekend. So that'll get me six done. That should get me up to 12, right? Because I've already got six done, I think. So then if we do one a day for Tuesday, Wednesday, we should be able to go for next weekend. Anyway, so as you can see here, right? So Mountain View, you can see I've created, right? With the 80, with the high overalls and stuff. Have yet to create the Flyers. What I did, if I haven't created them yet, I just put like a random WHL team on there, just as a placeholder. But anyway, as you can see, created all the teams. Created Mountain View, created Airdrie, Cochrane I've created, Coaldale, as you just saw, Red Deer, and Sylvan Lake I added today. So, those teams are all done. You know, gave them all, you know, somewhat accurate jerseys, I think. Right, everyone's got a home away and a third. Yeah, here's High River. So yeah, what I'm gonna do though, once all the teams are created, is we're gonna go over here into season mode. And what I had to do is find a league that had 15 teams. Right, they had the same 15 teams that the HJ does. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna drop them in to the Finnish Liga because there's 15 teams there. So I'll put the teams into the Liga, substitute all the teams. So yeah, I'll go into here and just do this for all of them, right? We'll put all the teams in there just like that. That's obviously the Three Hills Thrashers. Unfortunately, not all the towns are in the game, so most of them I had to just call Alberta. But anyway, so we'll substitute all the teams in the Liga. It'll make up a random schedule. There's no divisions, but that's fine. I haven't decided yet if I'm going to actually just use the Liga playoffs after this season's done, or if I'll do a separate playoff. I think I'll probably have to do a separate playoff, but that's okay. But anyway, so this way it'll track all the stats. Everyone can watch and see all the things. And, yeah, it'll be a good time. So, that's kind of what's happening. And, we should be ready to go by next weekend if I stay on creating teams. Of all the teams so far, like I said, I think I've created six. I want to say six. Let's see. So Mountain View, Sylvan Lake, Red Deer, obviously that's the first one I did. Coaldale, Cochrane, yeah, Airdrie, six. So I've created six of the teams so far. So after I'm done doing that, we'll be able to start the season. So yeah, should be good. If you're watching this tonight, my plan right now is to kind of take the last like 5 years of the league, like 2016 to 2020, and just kind of make a best of team. But if you weren't on any of those teams and you're watching this right now and you plan on watching the streams, you know, we probably won't broadcast every game, but we'll pick, you know, a couple games a night sort of thing. But if you're going to watch the streams and you want to be in the game, even if you weren't in the league 2016 to 2020, let me know if you're going to watch and we'll make you too. So yeah, you can let me know on Twitter at SimSots or here on YouTube, whatever you want to do. Anyway, should be fun. Let's have a good time, guys. Smell ya.